I'm super excited and fired up to create this croissant tires logo using shapes and lines on Canva. We're going to place it on a t-shirt. We're going to be using Photopea for that. Please join me. Open up canva.com and open a blank logo canvas. Then scroll to your lines and shapes and select your circle or press C on your keyboard. Reduce the size of your circle and then change the color and make it gold. What we're doing now, we're creating the tire rim and we're making the tire rim gold. I've seen it. I've seen gold tire rims. Next, let's head over to our lines and shape and add a triangle. With your triangle, reduce it and make the shape of your triangle with rounded ends. Change the color of your triangle and make it silver if you want to have a silver color. If you want to create gaps when we get to Photopea, then change it to white, which we're going to be doing a little bit later. And then place it on the round shape to create the design of your rim. So do that all the way through so that you have that triangle throughout the rim of your design. Next, press C for circle to add a circle. Reduce the size and make it color white or silver and place it in the middle of your rim. Our rim is coming along quite nicely. Next, we're going to go back to our shapes and we're going to add another triangle. On this triangle, we're going to change the color and make it gold and place it on the other triangles that are already there so that it creates that nice design that we're looking for. I can hear the demons call when they do what they do. And now I feel like taking off, find a place with a view. The pain is never gonna stop if it's controlling you. Next, you're gonna head over to our elements and you're going to search for a circle. This circle that we're looking for is the one that has an empty gap inside. Once you've found it, add it to your design and size it on top of the rim and then change the color and make it white or silver so that it covers the rim and starts creating a rim look like of what we're designing. So you can go pick the bad or the good, got a glass halfway. I know it's easier to hide and just to lay low. Not everyone in life has got a halo. Next, we're going to press C for circle and add another circle. Change the color and make it black for tire and then send to backward or position it to backward so that it looks like a tire. Adjust it and align it exactly the way that a tire would look like. If necessary, duplicate your silver circle or your white circle so that it covers all of the threads and the extra lines so that it doesn't look like you are not a professional designer. So add an extra silver line or a white line, adjust it on top so that it looks professional. And then your next step is to add tire-like threads on your design. So what you would do then, you would press L for line, adjust your line by making the ends rounded, and then start adding. They look like threads to me. I could be wrong. You know, I'm not a tire person. They look like tire threads and then start creating tire threads on your design all the way through on your tire so that it looks like a tire. Gotta get through, I just gotta get through. The last design on your queue, which is your tire, you're going to duplicate the thread and change color and make it a big nice black. Add it to your tire to portray or to show your cue. That's it. Congratulations, you've just created an amazing graphic. Next, you're going to group your design so that it's one and it's easy to move around. And then you're going to press T for text and add a T. We're going to be using Wedges as our font for this one. For our design purposes, we're going to be creating the tire look on our T as well. So we're going to be copying that line that we have on there and we're going to be adding it on our T so that it also shows and it looks like a tire. Remember, we're designing for a tire company. Next, we're going to be adding the same line to our tire queue and showing it like it's a moving tire. So we're going to be adding three lines that show movement on our design. Our last step is to add the name of the company. So we're going to press T for text, and we're going to type the Quasar Tire's name. We're also going to be using the Wedges font because it's nice and rounded and it looks like tires. And then we're going to add a nice border around it using lines. We're also going to add movement on the border so that it looks like a tire as well. So this is like a really design choice that I'm doing now. You could also add effects on the tire name so that you have emptiness. So you could play around with different kinds of design until you get what you like and what the customer likes and what's going to resonate with the customer's clients that are going to be buying tires from this company. Have fun with it. Find a solution, my evolution. A place like this, it didn't exist. You made it like this. So you can go pick the bad or the good. What I want to share with you is, if you do want to support the channel and help me continue creating amazing logos and amazing content, please head over to the documents that I use and the software that I use and use the links that I share, because YouTube or whoever I'm promoting, like Canva, when you upgrade, Canva shares commission with me at no extra charge to you. Or if you go to Amazon and you buy that extension that helps you design on your phone, it helps me continue doing this amazing work that I think you appreciate. So head over to my links below and then support the channel and support my work. I do appreciate to anybody and everybody that has been supporting the channel. Next, we're going to head over to downloading the content. We're going to click on share, and then we're going to download the 2D logo using our Canva Pro as with the transparent background. So we're going to download it as a PNG or an SVG if you do have Canva Pro, because with SVG, it comes out amazing and professional and vector looking like. Next step is to add our 2D logo to a mockup, whether it is a logo mockup or whether it's a t-shirt mockup. So you're going to click on templates to access different kinds of templates. Then you're going to select mockups. With your mockups, you can pick any mockups you want to use. We're going to scroll down and use a t-shirt for this quick example, and then we open up the t-shirt mockup. We're going to double click where it says your design here, and we're going to click and hide the company slogan, the logo here, as well as the infinity triangle colorful. We're going to hide those, and then we're going to click and drag our 2D to our canvas. We're going to align it and adjust it to the canvas itself, and then we press Command S to save it as a smart object. If you're using Windows, you're going to press Ctrl S, and then you press on the first tag that says logo to find your 3D converted or added to your t-shirt design. By the way, if you want to achieve a logo design on a mockup and you want to create those gaps, you can use remove.bg, and then it will allow you to have those beautiful gaps, and click on download and add it to your mockup on Photopea. We don't only do Canva logos on this channel, we do animation on Canva, this new AI that's available. Go watch this video to learn all about Canva's AI. I will see you on the next video.